Hi, in this video I'm going to discuss the research in State of Survival. And I'm going to look at both the your personal research and the Alliance research. First, I'm going to have a look at the personal research. So the most important thing is that you have your research speed as fast as possible, as high as possible. You want to keep always researching something, and there are definitely certain projects that are more beneficial than other projects, but basically you just want to keep on doing research. I will share some tips about the things you can best pay attention to. But first, have a look at the research speed. I'm just first going to share how I am doing. I'm not doing very well yet, but 38.9% is quite a reasonable research speed. So how you can improve this is in various ways. You can actually improve it with research, so there are certain tech improvement projects. If you have a chance to do these, definitely do them. I say definitely, I mean, you should look at the time. Certain projects take a huge amount of time, but if it is doable, I would do it. There's a lot of research to be done in this tree, but and maybe more importantly, there's a lot, the combat tree even has a lot more, and if you improve that research speed early on, definitely you can finish it faster. And knowing this game maker, they will introduce newer research later on with potentially even longer timers. So increasing the research speed is often worth it. Another great way to improve it is by increasing the XP level of your chief. That will give you talent points, and those talent points you can assign to the war or the economy project. You always should only assign it to one of the two trees or projects, because that is, you should, if you are working on starting construction, starting research, doing gathering, make sure you have economy active. If you're later going to go to war, switch to a war. That doesn't cost you much alliance credits, but the benefit for both is huge. And the more points you have, the huger the benefit is. I'm currently level 42, but it's really a very good level to have is 44. When you have reached 44, that will allow you to max out the second tech improvement project, which gives you 3% for each level, so that is a total of 30%. So that is definitely a huge increase if you compare it to the total you saw that I had so far with only one level done, so only 3 of the 30%. So try to aim for that. The best way to get chief XP is with the growth missions, which basically mean don't focus just on your headquarters, but focus on all buildings. I'm currently having my headquarters at 26, actually did start headquarters 27, but I'm not speeding it up at the moment. The past couple of days I've used up a lot of speed ups and a lot of focus to upgrade all my other buildings to level 25 and 26. Currently I still have 5 buildings to go, including the warehouse that I'm doing now, to go to 26. For the rest I have everything already at 26. So that is definitely something that I can recommend. When you have your economy tree on, you also have this rapid development talent. So some people think this only works for construction, but it actually also works for research. So I try to, whenever I can, and now it's still quite far away, but for example, tomorrow around this time, I'm probably going to, currently I have my, I have both construction and research speed, research and construction going on. But what I typically do, for example, if this talent is available and my construction is finished and my research still has a couple of hours to go, I will speed up those few hours and then I start another research, making use of that rapid development talent at the same time that I start another construction. So that is that tactic can save you a lot of time. Otherwise, 2 hours later, you start your research without that additional boost of 20%, and that will make if you have researchers that go for 2, 3, 4, 5 days, 20% is going to save you a lot of time. So in that case, spending a few speed ups can save you a lot more than actually those hours. So that is definitely something you should pay attention to in my eyes. There are a couple of other things, like having a high assembly point so that you can get many helps. That is, that can help you. And in the Alliance research that we will discuss later, there are also some projects that increase the number of helps. That can definitely help you, but doesn't help you as much as increasing your research speed directly. And one more thing relating to research, how you can speed things up, before I look at the projects that you can focus on, is these research tasks. So normally, I think it rotates every 3 hours. Normally, I don't do the plunder one because I don't like attacking. I actually prefer to be in a state where there is no attacking outside of the kill events, because I think everybody should have chance to grow. And if you do randomly attacks, even if you sometimes in our state they had, you can attack anyone but not the top 10 alliances. This kind of thing is just frustrating for the smaller players that still want to grow. So my personal preference, and that's why I also live by, don't attack outside of the kill events. So I don't complete those plunder ones, but for the rest I tend to complete all of them, and that also reduces a bit of time. Also not much, it's just a fixed time, but it reduces a bit of time from certain research projects. Okay, for the research in general, my initial focus, if I and when I started researching, is development. I like the more beds to increase your hospital capacity, but the main reason is the tool improvement, tech improvement, and training yard. So those projects, tool improvement, training yards, tech improvement, they increase, do I say it correctly? Oh no, sorry, I should say the training routines. So the training routines, tech improvement, and tool improvement, those increase your training speed, your research speed, and your building speed. So those are, in my eye, very important. So far, I have tried to do them each time when they became available. Only recently, tool improvement became available, tool improvement 6, level 3, and then I look at, what? 8 days, well, that is was a bit too much for me to have a 2.5% increase. Then I preferred to go to the next 3. Actually, initially in economy, I also did a lot because I thought getting resources would be a huge issue, which turns out it's not. So you can still, I wouldn't spend much at all on the resource production projects, like the sorting tech and fertilizer tech. The early ones were very cheap, and the later ones are also still quite cheap, but I wouldn't, if I look at it again, I wouldn't spend much effort on that. And even on the haulage ones, they increase the gathering speed, but that is not really necessary so far. So not really sure whether that is worth it. So far I have have stopped caring much about the economy tree. What I do, I use a settlement buff that increases the gathering speed for 24 hours with 100%, and I use that all whenever I'm gathering, and that is way more effective and easier than putting a lot of focus on those haulage projects. The main thing that you want to do, if you don't improve things in the development tree, then you want to go for the battle tree. And basically you want to do everything here, although there are certain things that are more interesting than other things. I think March capacity is definitely something that is very interesting. You should consider that every troop has its own strength. And especially if you look at infantry and if you look at hunters, infantry is really a defensive troop. The basic stats of infantry is focusing on health and defense. For hunters, the basic stats are attack and lethality. So you should do research, with research, you should actually focus on increasing those. I've not really followed my own advice. I've done everything because sometimes it's also quite cheap. But those are the important things. So if you, yeah, your hunters have already a good attack, so you should improve that with a percentage. And improving the defense of your hunters with a percentage, okay, it's cheaper research-wise, but it also benefits you less. And for defensive usage, you should use your infantry. So that is something to keep in mind as well. For the rest, I would say that most of the things are useful, or all things are useful in the battle tree. So just do everything. Currently, I'm working my way towards march capacity 5, as I feel like march capacity is really a very very important one. I think that's all I wanted to say about the personal research. Now also a bit about the alliance research, not too much. Don't know if any of you who are watching this are in the R5 or R4 of your alliance, but then you can take this into consideration when deciding which projects to focus on. Any ambitious alliance should first max out all possible alliance membership projects. This increases your membership limit from 50 to 100 in total, and that should definitely be your only focus in the beginning. If you are an ambitious alliance, just get that to 100 as soon as possible, because the power of your alliance is for a very, and yeah, your the success of your alliance is for a very large part determined by having a lot of active members, ideally 100. That makes sure you can do a lot better in events and all of you can grow better. So that should be your core focus. One project that is not so relevant in my eyes is the rally slots. This determines the rally slots against other chiefs. But actually, normally the rally capacity is a problem, not the number of rally slots. And if you have a number of rally slots, if you need more people joining your rallies, that probably means that the ones who did join sent only a small amount of troops, probably not so strong players. So you can wonder, do you really want to rally another chief with those players in your rally? So don't focus. It sounds interesting, but it's not interesting at all, actually. Also here with this research, and maybe more true than with others, because here I think it is as expensive, don't focus on things like infantry attack first. You go for your infantry defense and infantry health, and not for your infantry attack and your infantry damage. And similar for the ranged, you go for your ranged attack and ranged damage, but not for your ranged defense or ranged health. Those are things definitely you can do later, but not, that shouldn't be your first focus. I think ranged damage is kind of the same as ranged lethality, as far as I have seen it. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. One other thing that I don't fully understand is the Alliance Hospital capacity, because so far I haven't seen the Alliance Hospital building. I don't know whether that's just me or whether it really isn't there yet. Either way, you might wonder if you really want to focus on that. Similar games by the same maker had an Alliance Hospital, but getting your troops in there was actually not so beneficial, because you needed to use your Alliance credits to get them out, which was very... it cost a lot of Alliance credits and you could do better things with those. So actually people were quite frustrated. And in the end, in the games that I played, most Alliances just decided to not build the Alliance Hospital. So if it is introduced, or will be introduced, and it will have a similar function, not really sure whether focusing on the capacity is good. Whether you go for things like timer help duration first and timer helps, or whether you focus purely on combat projects, that is kind of a matter of taste, and you can also mix it up a bit. It is not. If you can do very cheap, in a very cheap way, in a very short way, because the higher the level, the more time these projects take. If you can, do it in a very quick and easy way, you can increase your timer helps. Yeah, why not? Why not do it? But in the long run, I think you are going to benefit more from the combat boosts. I'm also not so sure about the reinforcement capacity, whether that's really the most interesting stat. I would probably prefer the the combat boost. But again, if you can do that for a cheap way, like doing level 7 tech on combat, or doing the reinforcement capacity on level 4, at a certain moment, yeah, you might feel like, oh, this is so fast, let's do that. But I wouldn't do it like this to increase it first without having done any of the combat projects. Okay, yeah, that was my feedback on the research, my tips on research. If you have any questions or any comments, that is always much appreciated, and thanks for watching this video.